Hello everyone, myself Sonia Yadav, Assistant Professor, SGT College of Pharmacy, SGT University, Gurugram. Today we'll discuss the topic adsorption. The contents to be covered during this presentation are definition, cause, classification, isotherms, and applications of adsorption. Now, what is adsorption? Adsorption is a process that occurs when a gas or liquid solute accumulates on the surface of solid or liquid, forming a molecular layer on that surface. Now, what is the difference between adsorption and absorption? Absorption is a bulk phenomena, whereas adsorption is a surface phenomena. Now, why does adsorption occur? It is a consequence of surface energy. Atoms on the surface experience a bond deficiency because they are not wholly surrounded by other atoms. Now, there are two types of adsorption. One is physical adsorption and chemical adsorption or chemisorption. Physical adsorption occurs due to van der Waals forces of attraction, whereas in case of chemical adsorption or chemisorption, there is chemical bond formation. Comparison of physical adsorption and chemisorption. It is physical adsorption is caused by van der Waals forces of attraction, whereas chemical adsorption is due to chemical bond formation. Depends on nature of gas, whereas in case of chemical adsorption, it is much more specific as compared to physical adsorption. Heat of adsorption is small in case of physical adsorption, and in case of chemical adsorption, heat of adsorption is large. Physical adsorption is a reversible process. That means the gas or liquid adsorbed on the surface of solid or liquid converted back due to conditions, whereas in case of chemical adsorption, the process is irreversible. Physical adsorption occurs rapidly at low temperature, whereas chemical adsorption occurs rapidly at higher temperature. Increase of pressure increases adsorption and decrease of pressure decreases adsorption. It is a case for physical adsorption, whereas in case of chemical adsorption, there is no such effect on chemical adsorption. Physical adsorption is a reversible process, whereas chemical adsorption is a irreversible process. Physical adsorption occurs rapidly at low temperature, whereas in case of chemical adsorption, increase of temperature increases adsorption. Effect of pressure on physical and chemical adsorption. Increase of pressure increases adsorption, decrease of pressure decreases physical adsorption. Whereas in case of chemical adsorption, there is no such effect of pressure on chemical adsorption. Physical adsorption forms multi-molecular layer on adsorbent surface. In case of chemical adsorption, it forms unimolecular layer. Now, adsorption isotherms. In adsorption isotherms, we plot a graph of the amount of adsorbate on the adsorbent as a function of its pressure, that is in case of gas, or concentration in case of liquid at constant temperature. The first isotherm which we are going to discuss is Friedlich isotherm. It is given by Friedlich and Cluster in 1909. The empirical formula for Friedlich isotherm is Q is equal to Kp 1 by n, or Q is equal to Kc 1 by n. Limitation for Friedlich isotherm is it fails at high pressure. The term, these are the following terms which are to be used in the Friedlich isotherm. Now, Langmuir isotherm, it is given by Erwin Langmuir in 1916. These are the following assumption which are made by Langmuir are: the layer of the gas adsorbed on the solid surface is one molecule thick. The adsorbed layer is uniform all over the adsorbent. There is no interaction between the adjacent adsorbed molecule. The formula for Langmuir isotherm is Q is equal to Q max Kc upon 1 plus Kc. Next isotherm is Bett isotherm, given by Stephen Brunner, Paul Hughes Emmett and Edward Teller in 1938. These are the assumptions given by Bett, and this is the empirical formula for Bett isotherm. Applications of adsorption: production of high vacuum. In this partially evacuated vessel is connected to a container of activated charcoal. This activated charcoal adsorb all the gases present in the vessel and result in the production of high vacuum. Next application is for making gas mask. Gas masks are device contain an adsorbent, that is activated charcoal, or a series of adsorbent. These adsorbent remove poisonous gases and result in the purification of air that we breathe. Next application is removal of coloring matter from solution. The activated charcoal adsorb all the colored particles present in the solution and resulting in the production of clear solution. In this we can use animal charcoal or activated charcoal. Adsorption process can also be used in case of chromatographic analysis. In this the adsorbent that is used is silica gel. In chromatography the process of adsorption is used in case of thin layer chromatography, and we can separate small quantities of components into individual. At last, from this presentation we can conclude that adsorption is a surface phenomena. In case of physical adsorption, van der Waal forces of attraction are there, and in case of chemical adsorption, there is chemical bond formation. Applications of adsorptions are production of high vacuum, gas mask making, removal of coloring impurities, and in chromatographic analysis. Thank you and have a nice day.